One of the things that I appreciate about all of the intros that we do on TCM is that they're written as kind of a collective effort. And there is a real sense of sharing knowledge and having the ability to check in with folks who are really interested in and knowledgeable about the histories of these films.
I see our role as TCM hosts as being like a gateway to the viewer's cinematic experience.
We show better than 3,000 movies a year. It is inevitable that some of those films are going to have some content that is problematic.
If I'm showing a film like The Jazz Singer, I try to say a lot about the style of the film, but then it's incumbent upon me to point out something that's going to be glaring to many viewers now, which is that Al Jolson performs in blackface in that film. So providing some of the historical and social context for blackface performance is an aspect of explaining why it is that that film and that star, Al Jolson, was just so popular.
But that's why we're here, to add some context, to add some explanation, to warn people in extreme examples of something that's going to pop up in the film that might be jarring or uncomfortable or offensive.
I am definitely this time going to call in the police.
We've changed. We've grown a great deal as a society. Our wheelhouse is movies from the 30s, 40s, and 50s, so we are inevitably going to run into issues.
If I had any sense, I'd walk out on you.
You haven't got any sense.
Dan Duryea made his whole career out of hitting women, but it's a major part of Dan Duryea's career, and he's a major film noir star. So I always put this in context.
Well, don't get sore.
Well, then don't tell me I'm crazy.
I really look at these film by film, case by case. I don't have hard and fast rules about what should be pointed out and should not.
I look at what the theme of the night is, and if it's something that really fits in with the overall discussion of what we're talking about that night.
Let's go!
Let's take Native Americans, and we're showing cowboy movies. When it is a principal part of the story that we neglect to mention that in many cases these Native Americans were fighting aggressive settlers and they were fighting to preserve their very existence, I think it's our obligation to address that.
Hey, you won't help him that way.
Keep your black hands off my boy.
The film No Way Out, that is an incredible incendiary film about racism.
Look, I'm trying to help your brother. Why don't you just shut up?
You watch yourself, black boy. Watch how you talk to me.
I obviously caution people that they're going to hear stuff that's going to really, really disturb them.
We can be happy. We've got a right to be.
For more than 80 years, people have had an issue with Gone with the Wind. You see it in the scroll right at the beginning of the movie that tells you this is a movie that looks back upon the era of slavery with a wistful, romantic memory. Of course we were going to continue showing Gone with the Wind. That was really never discussed. It is not merely a movie that romanticizes slavery. It is also a movie that brought, which was rare at the time, a willfully empowered female character.
You'll be coming to Atlanta when he gets his leave, and you're sitting there waiting for him just like a spider.
Hattie McDaniel's performance is a huge part of Gone with the Wind's legacy. Not showing Gone with the Wind takes the critical history of Hattie McDaniel's performance out of the public eye.
I think anytime you edit offensive content out of a film or you delete a film from the film canon, you're saying in a sense that racism, sexism, homophobia, transphobia never existed.
If we don't know where we've been, we'll never know where we're going. If we want to know where we're going, we have to know where we've been in the past.
You're tearing me apart!
We created an entire language of cinema through these movies that now is the common language that everybody shares. I do not want to imagine a world where you can't see them.
What we're trying to do is we're trying to engage our viewers and get them to think about why it is that these films are important and interesting. And if there's a way that we can signal some aspects of the films that gets people to dig more deeply into the people and the context that are involved in the making of these films, then we've done our job well.